the way it seems. I like to go to Harvard and go in your face. And no matter,
yeah, no matter
what you do,
what
you do, your friends don't appreciate. All you got to do is just
steal it away.
Go down on
go
your
down
knees.
Come on, Jesus,
be Lord.
Come on, Jesus,
I need you to see.
Come on, let's see
about. Can I say that again? When you sing, I like to know the promise. Yeah. And I glow in your face. You know, and no matter. All you got to do is just
steal away.
Go down on
your knees.
Tell God.
Tell
him that we're sad.
Come on.
Please, Lord.
Come on, Jesus.
I need you to see.
Come on and see about.
Let me say one thing to you. The right way is a narrow way. Don't have no good standing. Y'all know what? Since I started on my Christian journey, I found that Jesus, He's my only friend. And when I'm in the trouble, I go down on my knees. Tell God,
tell
Him how much I am. Anybody you can feel it? Anybody here, have you tried it, Lord? Have you tried Jesus? Won't God take away? Won't God take away? Have you been good to you? Have you been good to you? I got one more question, then I'm gonna leave it alone. My grandmama told me a long, long time ago, you may not come where you want, but in that long time, won't God make a way? Have you been good to you? Stand up on your feet, get up on your feet, and give God some praise. Help to get the Jesus, get the holy name. Come on again in the praise. Give my God some praise. Won't He make a way? Bring that old man Daniel, down in the lion's den. Did He make a way? Look at old Joe, on his bed of affliction. He was sick so long, they infected him. Help the old Joe phone. Joe, I came to Joe. You are the best of God. He made you think like a foolish. See like a foolish woman. I ain't going nowhere. I'm gonna stay right here. Look at old Joe. Waiting on the Lord. Look at the Hebrew children. Down in the midst of the furnace, look at Nebuchadnezzar. He told my boy, I see dreams. Long as breath is cold. Oh, I'll be holding a bow. Won't He make a way? Won't God make a way? Won't God make a way? Won't He make a way? Did you get that power? 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 Won't He make a way? Won't God make a way? Let me tell you what He needs. Let me tell you what He needs. need to speak. About healing. Yeah. Won't God make a way? You ought to say, yeah. 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 Won't God make a way? Woo. Yeah.
Wonderful house of God. We're so grateful and thankful. We give honor to your very fine pastor. Let's give him a hand. Praise God. Bless you. Thank you. I've never been introduced in such a magnitude way, I tell you. I thank you so kindly. And to Reverend DeNoz, one I've been knowing down through the years. Amen. Let's give him a hand. Praise. Amen. For this work that he continued to do in the Lord. Amen. To Reverend Edwards, give her a hand. Praise. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And to Allen Chapel, we say thank you. Amen. For inviting the BCP chapels. We're so grateful and thankful. Gonna ask them to stand right quickly. Boone, Combo, and Patillo, thank you so much. I ask my deaconess to wear their choir. I thank them for being obedient. Amen. Ushers, thank you so much for being with us this afternoon. And what can I say about this choir?
All right.
We travel all over doing the work of the Lord. And I want to say this about them. Number one, because it's true. Mm-hmm. I've never worked with such faithful people.
All right.
All right.
In all days of my life. They travel with us. They're there when we get there. They are so grateful and humble, and there is a reward.
All right.
And I often tell them and I remind them they ain't doing it for Carl Dickens. You see, some folk can't sing because they're doing it for themselves.
All right.
Some folk can't sing because they're so pretty they want the folk to run all down the aisle. I can assure you they know why they are singing.
All right. Yeah.
They are singing because his name was Jesus.
Yeah.
Is that all right?
All right.
I often tell my people, Pastor, that don't travel with me if you're going for me. Mm-hmm. Travel with me when you're going to do the work of the Lord.
All right. Yeah.
Because that's what we promise God.
All right.
When we install them, when we put them on the boards, they promise, they oath is to God.
All right.
And if you ain't going, that's on you and your God. Isn't that all right?
All right.
Amen. Just so grateful to be here. I see so many. Saw one of my school teachers earlier, Mr. Loach.
Oh, she
in the back. All right, I can't even remember what grade she taught me. I really can't. But she taught me in one of them. Amen. So any mistakes today, blame them on her.
All right.
No, I just said, you can't blame them on her. She didn't have much to work with. So good to us all the time.
All right.
And to be able to come, I've been excited ever since the pastor called me to come and to be able to serve with you on 149 years. Give yourselves a hand.
All right.
After pastoring 17 years, I know how it is to keep pushing up the road. Because somewhere up that hill, you lose a lot of foot.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Everybody ain't pushing.
All right.
And it's hard to keep 149 years going.
Yeah.
Some of your pushes.
All right.
So you have to thank God for what you have.
All right.
And keep on pushing, because those that are pushing, God will give them strength.
Come on.
Push a little more.
Yeah.
Amen. So just continue to do the work of the Lord.
Yeah.
I didn't come to spend a long time, but I did come to spend effective time.
Yeah.
And in my time that I have, I promise God to tell you the truth.
All right.
And God have blessed me so I can preach an hour and a half if I have to.
All right.
And God have blessed me, I can preach 10 minutes.
All right.
If I have to.
Amen.
But if you say amen, I can sit it on down because I know you get it.
All right.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Y'all say amen. I won't preach an hour and a half. Amen. We'll let y'all go. Because I understand we got something to eat, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. I know it won't be an hour and a half. That's something that we do quite well. It's already been read in your hearing. The book of Ephesians, the first chapter, if you will, find it for us. Ephesians, the first chapter, this is what God had given me. And when I received the assignment from your pastor, I went praying right away. This is where God led me. Ephesians chapter 1, started in 19. And what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us, Lord, who believe? Tell your neighbors about the believer. According to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Jesus. And that wrought means build or create. When he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in heavenly places.
Yeah.
So the first thing I want to identify today, everybody ought to know where Jesus is.
All right.
Because he tells us in the text that he set him at his own right hand in heavenly places.
Yeah, yeah.
Far above all principalities, tell your neighbor, far above.
Far above.
And power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in which is to come.
Mm-hmm.
And I pray that I can take a moment on the world to come. Nobody, everybody want to talk about this world.
Yeah.
And nobody want to talk about the world to come.
All right.
Because the same man in charge of this world is in charge of the world to come.
All right.
I believe that people would be more faithful in this world.
All right.
If they knew it determined how we're going to live in the other world.
All right.
This evening in this 149th church anniversary, the value of the church. The value of the church. Master, I thank you now as you allow me to stand behind the most sacred rostrum, I ask you to speak through these clear lips of mine. The only preacher is your Holy Spirit. Let him teach us today as we celebrate on 149 years. We ask this in your power. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
The value of the church. It is God's intent that you will never ever, everyone that's here, will look at the church the same after this message.
All right.
It is God's desire for you to understand this afternoon the value of the church. Is that all right?
All right. Yeah.
I believe that when we understand the value of something,
yeah,
I believe that we handle it differently.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I believe that the reason why the churches are the way they are and the churches are slack is because the people don't know the value of what they have.
All right. Yeah. All right.
Let's use your house.
Yeah.
And they ask you what's your house.